And we're now joined by the chief of the PNP-CIDG, Brigadier General Nicolas Torre III. General, good morning to you.
Good morning, Ms. Karen, and to all your listeners.
Malacanang has issued a statement considering the vice president's statements as an active threat. When the statement of an active threat is made, what kind of action does the PNP take? What is the procedure that the PNP underscores when an active threat against the president is considered?
Well, considering that it's an active threat against the president, the first and foremost agency that will take care of it is the Presidential Security Command. We will take cue from the PSC, whatever their orders are, the specific orders and requests that they will make to the PNP, that's what we'll act on. So at the moment, we are conducting our motu proprio investigation regarding this matter so that we'll be ready once this specific orders comes to us.
Okay. So, General, no order coming from the Presidential Security Group or Malacanang has been passed on to the PNP in what to take? Not yet.
Ma'am, that will be at the, at the level of my chief PNP if he has received such kind of order. It will be through him, and he will be the one who will tell me that. As of the moment, the chief PNP had already ordered me to conduct an investigation regarding this matter, and I'm not very sure if the order is because it was given to him by the PSC or not.
What kind of investigation will you be conducting, considering the vice president has said she had spoken to a specific individual? Does that mean you will be speaking to the vice president?
For CIDG, this will be a criminal investigation. We will be first and foremost establishing the facts of the case, and if it needs an interview with the vice president, we'll do it through channels.
But will that mean that you will be interviewing the vice president?
Well, according to the investigation plan that we had made right now, there's a possibility. There's a possibility, but it's not on the top priority.
Okay, so there's a possibility. So if it's not on the top priority, and if the vice president refuses, hypothetically, to be questioned by the PNP, what kind of investigation will you make? How far can it go?
Yeah, it will be... Obviously, the vice president always has the right to refuse any subpoena or summons that will be issued by anybody. You know? So we can proceed. Actually, we can proceed. Just like in any criminal investigation, we don't need the statement of the main actor in the criminal investigation. Then we establish the facts based on the other circumstances. And then once the case is completed, it will be submitted to the proper forum.
Okay. Another question is, what is the standard operating procedure against making threats with the president of the country? Are you able to arrest any individual that makes an active threat? Or do you still need an arrest warrant to be issued by the court?
The grave threats case is penalized in the revised penal code, but if it involves the president, it is an altogether different ballgame, and another law comes in. Now, if you are referring to the previous threat that was made by a teacher against the former President Duterte, and wherein the case there is the treatment there is a bit different from what you are seeing right now. Well, obviously, it's because of the status of the person who made the threats. On that case, the threat maker was unknown. His affiliations are unknown. His whereabouts were unknown. So the Presidential Security Group then made a very, very fast investigation and located the suspect and located the subject and arrested him. In this case, however, this is a case wherein it's a bit peculiar, first time in history, that the vice president making a direct threat against the sitting president. So the treatment is a bit different, considering that obviously.
But why should there be
subject?
But why
we know.
General, I'm hearing you. Why should there be a different treatment? So I'd just like to read that part. This was so the audience has a fuller picture. This was in May.
The current direction is asking me why there is a double standard. This is definitely one of the cases where the judgment and the discretion of the investigators will come in. First and foremost, it's the vice president. We know where she is. We know who she is. We know her affiliations. We know her capabilities. And we know the public lives of the vice president. So this is not something that you investigate as if you are looking for somebody who is nameless, faceless, and somebody that we don't know altogether. So this is essentially, I told you before, that this is the whole of the Presidential Security Command. We'll be taking orders from them, whatever direction that they want to guide this investigation to lead this investigation to. So I'll wait for that formal direction kung ano man ang kanilang gusto mangyari dito.
Okay, so may I just go back to May 2020? So in May 2020, the NBI arrested a teacher who posted on Facebook, I believe, about a reward to kill former President Duterte. So the teacher actually underwent an inquest for inciting to sedition related to cybercrime and violation of the Code of Ethics for public officials and employees. I wanted to ask you, is the vice president immune from suit? Is she immune from suit? Because the president is while in office, but is the vice president immune from suit?
Ma'am, please direct your questions to the NBI who did that answer, who made that answer, who made that call before. And also, if on the legal questions, please direct your questions to the proper authorities, the DOJ.
Yeah, because during the time of former President Duterte, the teacher who threatened former President Duterte, actually, it was a warrantless arrest. What authorities did was a warrantless arrest.
And right now, I'm being called now for a conference. Kung ano man ang inyong itanong pa, ma'am, please make it now. Because I have to really back off and attend to the other situations that I'm
Pero ang tanong ko lang sa inyo, sir, before I let you go, General, naniniwala ba kayo na dapat may double standard? Kung ang isang teacher, binantaan ang nakaupong pangulo, inaresto, ang vice-presidente po ba? Iba po ba?
Excuse me, I really have to go now.
All right, okay. Well, okay, so that was that. So the chief of the PNP-CIDG, Brigadier General Nicolas Torre III, I guess perhaps he just couldn't answer some of the questions that we had for him.